guard, a 6'1" sophomore out of Spring Valley, New York, number 0, Ricky McNeil. At guard, a 6'6" freshman of Hartford, Connecticut, number 2, E.J. Crawford. At guard, a 6'5" junior of Rochester, New York, number 15, Deshaun Lunch. Guard, a 6'2" senior of Brooklyn, New York, number 10, John Sevier. And forward, a 6'8" senior of Jamaica, New York, number 23, Jordan Washington. Coaches at Bryan College, Director of Operations, Yusuf Fitzgerald. Assistant coaches are Brock Erickson and Mark Calzanetti. Associate head coach, Jared Grasso. And ladies and gentlemen, seventh season of Iona College, the head coach,
low 60s. That means use the shot clock effectively, extra pass, make sure that the press, if it does come, does not speed us up, get a good shot every time down, and really defend them and make them not feel comfortable shooting the three as they want to do, and then crowd the lane against Washington.
Harris and Washington jump it off, and Iona gets the tip. They're going right to left as we see it seated across the floor from the Delaware bench. McGill goes over to Much on the right side. One dribble inside, it's Crawford. Now to Washington. That's their go-to guy. He shoots 60%, but he'll start 0 of 1 as he misses from the right block, rebounded by the Hens.
Good defense down on the low block. That was a high-low situation where Crawford was trying to dump it into Washington. Barnett Harris doing a nice job of staying between Washington and the basket.
We know what Barnett can do defensively. He struggled offensively, but there finds Piggott for a three in the corner. Missing, would have been an assist. And a good look from Harris if it fell through, rebounded by Iona.
Now, Iona does open up in that 2-3 zone we talked about. It's kind of passive. They really are inviting you to take some shots, and they'll then try to rebound the ball and push it up.
Point guard is Ricky McGill, the sophomore from Spring Valley, New York. This team has a good mix of very young guys and grad students and seniors. Severe. There's a grad student. Steps in for a two from the corner left side, missing, and a rebound to Ryan Daly.
Delaware with a little change up there, a little bit of a zone. Iona skipping it, which is a good maneuver against it. Good look, but a nice defensive rebound for Ryan Daly, working himself hard to get good position.
Daly at the foul line to Bryant, starting for the first time. Daly back on top, 15 to shoot, and Delaware being deliberate. They want to take their time offensively against this Iona zone. 9 to shoot. Mosley drives on Washington, gets the layup in, and Delaware on the board first. It's suit up.
Well, Mosley with a great first step, high off the glass. He has a great feel, Scott, for finding a way to get the shot off through contact, but also putting the ball in the exact right place on the backboard.
Good description by you. I'm always impressed with his ability to not have his shot blocked against taller players. Washington, jumper is good from about 17 right side. He's one of two to start.
We talked about his low post presence, but he also has worked very hard in the offseason on his mid-range game, a very effective shooter from 15 and in.
Only plays 20 minutes per game, though. A guy that plays, I mean, that's almost 35 points per 40 minutes.
You're absolutely right, and that's because he gets into foul trouble. Very aggressive, and that's one thing Delaware wants to do is attack him offensively and see if they can't get him in foul trouble.
And Mosley did just that, lost the ball as he drove the baseline. Ball came loose and an offensive foul called against Iona. The ball was loose. Harris was in the mix trying to pick it up, and Deshaun Mutch kind of shoved him a little bit. That's the first foul on Iona, the first on Mutch.
Well, at times, Barnett Harris's defense is almost like an irritant. He's in there, and he has those great long arms and a lot of energy. He's not afraid to mix it up. Mutch just reacted to Barnett, giving him a little bit of pressure.
Daly on the kickout straight away. Three is good. He has been red hot as of late. 17 of 52 coming in. 33% from three, but much improved our last couple of games.
When Ryan Daly has time to shoot and gets prepared underneath the shot with his legs, he's a very effective shooter.
McGill has it knocked out of his hands. It goes into the backcourt. He can go get it. Brings it to the front court. 5-2, Delaware on top. They skip left to right. Mutch to the foul line. Corner to McGill. He gets right past Harris. Stops, kicks it back out. Mutch penetrates. Hop step, reverse. Cannot finish. It's tipped around. Missed, but tipped out again. Near half court, McGill center circle. Two offensive rebounds on this possession for Iona.
That was a great back tap by Mutch, which normally I don't like, but that time he knew every Delaware defender was had pressed in to help rebound. Good activity by Mutch down low.
Double team comes to Washington. He spins baseline away from it, and he is fouled on the shot attempt that does not fall. 16-52, first half, and Delaware up 5-2.
That was a quick baseline entry pass to Washington, and he immediately recognized that Barnett Harris had gotten caught on his top leg. He spun to his left shoulder. He's a right-hander, but it was a very quick spin. He caught Barnett on the top side and a really powerful, but I thought explosive move to get himself in good position to score.
And now Barnett's got to be careful. Obviously a starter tonight on the floor now with Washington as he misses the free throw, but he averages a foul about every 5 minutes he's out there. He does get himself into foul trouble, and that's limited him. He mentioned that he only gets 7.7 minutes per game, but some of that is because he's gets into foul trouble a bit. So we'll see how well he can do against Washington, because he's going to be needed tonight, that's for sure.
And I'm a little surprised he's being subbed out here quite so quickly. That's a very short leash without fouls playing effectively. I don't know. Maybe he has a conditioning issue from time to time.
He does make his second free throw, and he has all three of Iona's points. They trail by two. Delaware gets it across half court against his zone as Bryant gets it over to Mosley.
It's a little bit of a matchup, Scott. It has man-to-man principles, but they are moving around with men. They have to communicate. Devon Pinkard with a beautiful spot-up shot.
Yeah, about a foot in from three-point range, so it's a two, but he just turned, saw an opening, and a good release from Pinkard. It's 7-3. Delaware on top by four as Cedric Kazmir checks in for the first time. Also, Taylor Besick into the game. Crawford straight away three. Line drive from Crawford, and it goes. 42% on the season from Crawford. He makes his first.
Crawford, a lefty. He's clearly got to be run off. A very fine spot-up shooter. You cannot allow a shooter like that to get his legs underneath him. You have to make him a dribbler.
Delaware with the basketball. I mentioned the name Taylor Besick. Might remain be familiar with that name from conference play. Former James Madison student-athlete. Transferred two seasons ago from the Dukes. Pinkard open for a three-ball from the right side on the wing, and Devon Pinkard's made his last two.
Well, he is terrific when he has time. That's a good find there by Delaware to get the ball to the hot shooter.
Severe trying to get three right back. Can't do it. Misses. Besick with their offensive board. He misses at the rim. Delaware with a 10-6 lead.
Besick, the second-best offensive rebounder on Iona. He's got to be blocked out every time. That time he had a free run at the basket, just shot it too quickly or he would have scored.
Baseline pass by Harris. He snuck it right in to Anthony Mosley, who got the layup to go. Barnett Harris is a sneaky good passer.
He certainly is. He has good vision. He's willing to throw it. He throws excellent bounce passes. But what I also liked on that, Scott, was kind of the backdoor-ish maneuver by Mosley to get himself open on the backside of the zone.
Kazmir. Pass to McGill. McGill, left elbow jump shot. Back iron, no good. And a rebound by Barnett Harris. Delaware doubling up Iona. 5 minutes into this one, it's 12-6.
Delaware, other than that one time down when Munch got a couple of rebounds, have done a nice job defending their glass. Barnett Harris there with an excellent block out on Taylor Besick.
Pinkert has had the hot hand, 2-of-3 today. Passes to Bryan, who stands at the free throw line. Drives, passes, man, to the rim. Besick got a piece, I believe, of the shot, and it's back to Iona.
No, he did. Darian Bryant might have been better served there to do a little jump stop and a fake because he had Besick full speed coming across from the other side.
Crawford to three. He misses strong, and talk about strong. That's a strong rebound for Barnett Harris, who gets a rebound, but then looks towards the bench and asks for a sub.
Well, Barnett has given him great minutes, high energy, and doing a nice job physically blocking out his assignment at the defensive end.
Here's your chance, Barnett, to be on the floor. You got to be dragged off the court, not asked to get off of it. And on the other end, Mosley, a dribble drive, ball goes out of bounds, and he'll get a break at 14:08. Delaware up 12-6 here at the Bob Carpenter Center. We'll take a break as we have immediate timeout here on 94.7 WDSD. Their home floor, and right now up 12-6 over visiting Iona. Coach Inglesby mixing up the starting lineup, putting Barnett Harris in to start to give this team energy, to give it life, and he has provided just that.
He certainly has. He's an emotional player, but I mean that in a good way. At 6'9", 215, which is not heavy, he's willing to mix it up in there. He's done a good job of blocking out three or four different times, two good defensive rebounds, an excellent find to Mosley along the baseline. Barnett has given them high-quality minutes this evening.
He will be on the bench coming out of the timeout as Carter checks in for the first time, as does Kasman Hayes. Delaware will inbound 7 on the shot clock. Daly just tried to inbound a moment ago from the baseline. It was knocked directly out of bounds, so 6 now. To Mosley, to Hayes with 4. 3, he gets a screen on the drive. Contact with 1 second left on the shot clock. He bounced into Taylor Besick, and Besick picks up his first.
One of the ways that I really like when Kasman Hayes attacks the basket is his ability with his right hand to still draw contact and hold the ball away and give himself for a chance for a three-point play. Kasman's at his best when he identifies driving lanes and attacks, especially early on, not settling for some of those long-range shots, and then allow himself to get into rhythm.
Hayes at the free throw line. Two things I like. I like him going to the free throw line, being able to see the ball go in, because he's shooting just 19% from the floor over the last 3 games. So he needs to see a shot fall, just 1 of 9 last time out against USF. I like him coming off the bench, being able to kind of see the flow of the game and then get into it. You can see the first possession he was out there offensively getting to the strike.
And a smart play, recognizing that the shot clock had almost expired, driving the ball. And I believe Taylor Besick bailed him out with a very bad foul coming across to help.
That was the second foul on Iona. 2 free throws good from Kaz, and it's 14-6 Delaware. Ball fake by Kazmir. Now he drives into traffic and draws contact. I believe Devon Pinkard will pick up his first, team second.
Well, Delaware's got to do a good job of chasing people off of the three-point line, as we described, because they are a high-volume three-point shooting team and a pretty solid one at 36% overall. But then they've got to have additional players in the lanes when they do drive it. You can't allow them access directly to the basket.
Free throw good from Kazmir, who's 11 of 12 this season coming into this contest now. 12 of 13 after the make, and a first or another substitution for Iona as Jan Svanderlick. I think I nailed that one after some trouble.
Yes, you did.
Trouble
and
in the Marist game.
Here's this pressure, this 2-2-1 three-quarter court. It's a little bit more of a harassment than trying to actually make a steal.
And they get a steal, though, behind the back pass after Much took it away. Now Much down the floor, lays it up and in. That's a quick 4 points in a row for Iona after two free throws remain.
Well, that can never happen. And the part of the problem is you can never dribble into a double team. If you see a double team coming, you either retreat dribble or you pick it up and execute out of it.
Now another strip. Carter lost it. Gets it back to Mosley, who spins blocking foul against Cassell, who just checked in. The grad transfer from UConn picks up his first.
When you're a big man and you're trapped out on the perimeter, generally that's with shorter players. Your first look should be long. Look underneath the basket, look to the middle, look to skip it, and then go back. And that time I think we got sped up. And that's one thing you have to try to do mentally against a pressure, Scott, is do not allow yourself to get out of sorts.
And that's Champ Mosley's job as the point guard on this team. Daly spins to Champ. At the elbow, back to Daly it goes, but in traffic, that's a second turnover as it's stolen away by Anthony Mosley. 14-10, Delaware leads. Three-pointer on the way from Kazmir, and what was a 7-0 run by Delaware is now a 7-0 run by Iona. It's 14-13.
Kazmir, not known for his three-point shooting, feels like he's in rhythm, so he's got to be guarded. You have to make those little adjustments throughout the game.
Hayes inside, bumped, no contact, can't get his own rebound after the miss. Washington, who re-enters the game, dribbles up across half court. Iona, a chance to take the lead for the first time tonight. A three ball by Kazmir, maybe a heat check for the youngster, and he misses that one short.
And that's regressing to the mean there. That was a quick, bad shot right in front of the Delaware bench, not with the, without even good form. That's the kind of shot that Delaware wants Iona to take.
12-25, first half. Daly has it stripped, gets it back baseline right to Pinkert on the wing to Daly, corner right side. He's made 1-3, can't make another. Rebounded by Kazmir on the weak side.
That came out of Ryan's hands a little flat. He needs to take his time, maybe get his legs underneath him a little bit more before he shoots it.
Daly's got three, five for Pinkert, four for Mosley, and two from Kazmir Hayes from the free throw line. Delaware up by one. They led by eight moments ago. Much to Svanderlick, and he misses a three from the left side.
An excellent contest there by Ryan Daly. Even though he didn't chase Svanderlick off the three, he made him very uncomfortable and rushed his shot.
And it's a one-point lead under 12. Next whistle will bring us to a timeout. 11:39 to be exact as Hayes dribbles right side on Cassell. Inside, misses on the layup. Carter gets his hands on what would have been a rebound, but Washington snares it for the Gales. Cassell brings it up.
Washington had great rebound position there, and that big frame did not allow Eric Carter to get himself inserted inside to get the offensive rebound.
Kazmir pass to Svanderlick, and a dribble handoff back to Cassell on the wing. Straight away, now pull up Jay above the free throw line, is strong, and Ryan Daly, very good rebounder, gets it for UD.
Cassell had a leg split there, which can never be a consistent shooting motion. That's a shot that Delaware wants him to take.
Iona still on a 7-0 run. Delaware struggled to score. They've made none in the last 2:51, and that'll continue after Pinker misses from the wing left side. Iona wants to push. They want to go fast. They've never led. Kazmir can change that. His jumper off the mark, though, and a rebound by Carter. Svanderlick gets his hand in there, nearly knocks it away, but Carter grips it and gets it to Mosley.
Now, that was a tough guy rebound by Eric Carter. I liked his aggression there. He ripped the ball, ripped it out of Svanderlick's hands, who almost had it in there and also got it underneath his chin.
An offensive foul on the other end is Carter trying to spin off Svanderlick to get position and grabbed his right arm. That's a turnover for Delaware, and that brings us to another timeout. 14-13 is the score. Delaware was on a 7-0 run. Iona is currently on a 7-0 run of their own. 10:30 left, first half. Back in a moment. Star Health at the University of Delaware. Star Health, a new direction in healthcare. 10:31, first half of basketball. I'm Scott Klatskin alongside Bill Harmon, courtside at the Valley Days broadcast table presented by Shell, where Delaware is 4-0 on the season. But right now, Iona getting things moving a bit offensively. They're on a 7-0 run. Delaware has gone cold. They've missed their last six shots.
Well, Kazmir got them going with a couple of good shots, one from the three and one from the mid-range. The ball needs, from Iona's standpoint, to go into Washington a lot more. They seem to forget about him. Maybe that's because head coach Tim Kloos is not here. Delaware is sharing the ball. They've just got to cut down on those turnovers, Scott.
Severe. Pass to Washington. There you go. He spins. One aggressive take, but Harris knocks it out of bounds with the block shot. Barnett Harris, defensive stopper.
Well, Barnett did a great job there of reading the fact that Washington does not have a left hand. He just sat on that right hand off the spin and blocked it out of bounds. I'd love to see Barnett block that to himself and initiate the fast break.
What a spark he has been in the starting lineup tonight. Ball is deflected out of the hands of Cassell. Pinkert ahead to Bryant, running the floor. Layup is good from the right side.
Darian Bryant got his hand in on the ball that deflected it to Devon Pinkert, who did a great job of identifying that Bryant was wide open on the right wing.
Delaware stops a 7-0 run. Washington, jumper from 17. That's a good-looking shot from the 6'8 senior.
Now, when he's made one, and you know the scouting report is he has a mid-range game, Barnett's got to close him out and make him a dribbler.
Harris with the basketball now on offense. Mosley left alone underneath, and Harris found him for the second time tonight. Two assists for Harris, both to Mosley.
It's an interesting matchup zone that Iona's playing here. They like to leave players wide open underneath the basket. A great find, Barnett, who did what we talked about. He looked deep, looked at the basket.
18-15, Delaware's lead. Approaching the nine-minute mark of the first half. Much with the basketball. Jab step and a pass to Fonderlich. Much gets it back. On the wing, Pinker defends. Five to shoot, crossover, foul line, inside the paint, and a whistle, offensive foul on Much, as it looked like Pinker took the charge.
Well, Pinker did a great job of identifying the fact that Much wanted to drive the ball. He had no attempt to pass the ball to a teammate. He dribbled it seven times without any sort of penetration. Then he put the ball on the floor. Devon is really good off the ball. He has a good sense of stepping in a help position, and he's willing to draw the charge. A nice defensive play there by the entire Delaware team, but especially Devon Pinker.
Second foul on Much, transfer from University of Buffalo. Delaware the basketball back. Hayes at half court. Kazmir defends. He spun out of a double team and finds the point guard, Mosley, who will run the offense starting on the left side. Inside out dribble brings it to the right. 15 is shoot. Cushing, who just entered, gets it back to Mosley. Mosley an open three, and it hits the front of the rim. No good. Rebounded by Crawford for Iona.
And that's a shame because Barnett Harris had great position underneath.
Washington running the floor. Gets a layup. Nice pass to him from McGill, who leads the team with four assists per game. Gets one there.
And we talked about Jordan Washington's speed, and there it was. That was a sprint, a rim-to-rim sprint that we talk about. That's what good big men do. Delaware's got to get people back, especially the defender, which was Barnett.
Harris, foul line jumper wide open, but probably not the shot Delaware wanted on that possession, up by one. Iona a chance to take their first lead. Good ball movement beyond the arc. Kazmir back to McGill. McGill brings it back out in front of the Delaware bench. Hand off to Kazmir, pass to McGill. Posting up is Washington. Right side, step back jumper, baseline, good, plus one. And Jordan Washington, for a guy that shoots 60%, I was thinking he's a dunk-only, put-back-only kind of guy. He has made three outside jumpers in traffic.
Well, he's got a great high release. When he's wide open, he's willing to shoot it. But I believe this might be a double foul.
It's a technical foul against Iona, I believe.
It's got to be on Washington, Scott, for something after the fact when he got hit, knocked to the floor.
Foul was on Barnett Harris, and Washington, I believe, because of he made the shot, his excitement, in turn, perhaps talking some smack to the defender, Harris, or another Delaware player in the area of a referee, in the technical foul called against Iona. So Washington will get a free throw to finish what could be a three-point play after Mosley shoots these two. He's made the first, and the second rolls in as well. So possible to get a plus one on this play after the free throw coming up by Washington, but he made a nice shot but gave two right back to Delaware.
Well, as a post player, you know you're going to get a lot of contact. You're going to get knocked to the floor. He's a senior. He's got to learn how to keep his emotions under control, especially when he's a player that does get in foul trouble, and a technical acts as a personal foul. So Washington has one.
Washington goes to the free throw line after Mosley gives Delaware the lead back 20-19. 8 minutes even remaining. Next whistle will send us to a timeout. Washington, one of two from the free throw line, now two of three as he ties the score at 20 all.
Taylor Besick will come into Washington, kind of getting that break that they have almost programmed in. That's the associate head coach, Jared Grasso, doing a nice job with the substitution patterns and a lot of pressure on him here to get a win on the road in the absence of head coach Tim Close.
I'm just so impressed by all that Washington does in about half the ball game. He plays 20 minutes a game, and you see, as you called him, the program breaks that he gets for breathers, but averaging about 34 points per 40 minutes on the floor. Bryant inside to Carter. That's good ball movement. A beautiful pass and the finish high by Eric Carter on the right block.
Four players touched it. We used the shot clock almost in its entirety. A great find by Darian Bryant driving down the left side and then an over-the-shoulder pass to Eric Carter, who finished under some pressure.
Severe baseline drive, pass baseline. Kazmir shot contested over Kazman Hayes, and he hits it.
Well, Kazmir has really been a pleasant surprise for Iona here tonight. Good long-range shooter, not known for that, but he's really playing hard at both ends.
He's got eight. Now Bryant to Kazman Hayes on the left side. Three right back for Delaware.
How about Darian Bryant here coming in and really playing with a great deal of energy. Two good passes in a row.
It's 25-23 Hens. Severe, another baseline drive left side to the right. Poked out of the hands of Kazmir. McGill gets it back to Crawford. Straight away three. Front rim, no, and a rebound by Cushing. He'll settle to Hayes.
A nice contest up top by Darian Bryant as Crawford, again, he splits his legs much like Sam Cassell Jr. That shot is never going to be consistent because his release point is going to be varied every time.
6:30 to go. Waiting on the media timeout, the next whistle. Cushing, a jumper from 15. Strong, tipped by Besick, tipped out by Daly, took it away, put it up. Besick blocked the shot off the window. Now Severe wants to push. McGill does not have numbers. He'll wait for teammates. And get it back to Severe, who checks with the coach for tonight, Jared Grasso.
How about a smart play there by Ricky McGill? I really like that. You can see what a savvy point guard he is, Scott. He had an opportunity to drive it there, but there were numbers back for Delaware. He withdraws the ball, and they run some offense.
Kazmir. Guarded by Hayes, slips to Crawford, who just missed a three. Six to shoot. McGill's going to have to work. Crossover on Daly. Shot over Ryan Daly. No good. Right side of the rim. And a rebound by Bryant with 5:47 first half.
Sometimes when you're a four-out team, you only have one post player available to rebound. And when you get down into the shot clock, it does not afford additional players in there for rebound position.
Carter dribbles around the arc, hands it off to Hayes. In the corner, it's Daly. Right baseline drive. Kick out to Bryant. 11 to shoot. A pass to Cushing. Corner is Daly. Daly guarded by the bigger Besick. Brings it back out. 5 to shoot. Picks up his dribble. 4 to shoot now. Carter's got to put it up. And an offensive foul for the second time tonight called against Eric Carter as Severe hit the deck. The turnover brings us to a break. 5:19 remaining. Delaware holding on to a 2-point advantage. It's 23 break, an offensive foul called against Eric Carter, who got the ball in the post against a smaller defender.
Well, Sapir was playing on his left shoulder, and Eric's got to just slow down a little bit. I know the shot clock was winding down, but he still had time to locate the defender. Maybe some more face-ups would help him. But also, if you see the defender there, just give him a little head and shoulders and then drop step away from him. Sevier was only in there to draw the charge. That was his only thing he could do defensively to stop Eric because of the mismatch.
Delaware's led by as many as 8. Iona had a one-point lead about 3 minutes ago. They can get a one-point lead with a 3 here. As we're back in action, Kazmir's played well. He's got 8, 10 for Washington to lead Iona. Kazmir, a 3 contested, and as well as he's played, he's also taken some equally bad shots.
Yeah, that was a back screen there. He read it perfectly, but the shot came out flat. A good late closeout by Anthony Mosley.
4:52 first half. Carter beyond the arc, picks up his dribble. Pass to Bryant off a screen. He was looking for Daly, couldn't get it to him. Mosley from the right wing. Stops at the mid-left block. Back out the Pinkerton. Started strong for Delaware. 8 to shoot between the circles is Mosley. About 2 feet higher than the free throw line. Mosley misses a shot. He knew it was off. Followed his shot. Gets it back. Shot punched by Taylor Besick on the putback. On the run is McGill. Flips it to Sevier. Left wing. Dribbling with his left hand. Finds Kazmir. He flips it back to Sevier. Squares. Fires. Cannot hit. And Pinkard, a defensive rebound.
Delaware continuing to do a good job defending the glass. They also did a great job there in transition, Scott, getting everybody back to thwart the transition offense of Iona, which they're known for.
Daly, few dribbles. He caught it inside the arc, dribbled back out, and passed to Mosley. Mosley working, and they're giving Mosley a look at a jump shot. He gets in close and misses high off the backboard. And that was a foul on Iona. Team going back to the bench. It's another media timeout. 3:56 remaining. So when we come back, Anthony Mosley at the free throw line where he's already made a pair of technical fouls. Delaware up by 2, 25-23. You're listening to 94.7 WDSD. Scott Klatskin alongside Bill Harmon. 25-23 is the score. Delaware on top. Past couple of possessions for Delaware as this one ended with Anthony Mosley going to the free throw line. The Hens have worked the clock down, the shot clock down before shooting. And this game, not a whole lot of points in it. That's how Coach Inglesby told us he wanted it played.
Not only does this lessen the number of possessions available for Iona in a game or in this half, it changes their demeanor. Now they've got to defend a little bit. Delaware is reversing the ball. Almost everybody's touching every possession. That's very smart. You've got guys that aren't used to defending for 30 seconds. Having to play it, it takes a little bit away from their offense then. So very, very good strategy here by Delaware and better execution.
Mosley 4-4 from the free throw line as he knocks in both. And Delaware's lead now 4, 27-23, 3:49 first half. Iona with the basketball. Washington back into the game. He's got 10 points leading Iona. Mosley also has 10 for Delaware. Cassell on the wing. Catch, shoot, 3. It rattles out. Cassell's taken the most 3-point shots on the team this season. He has not made close to the most amount, though, shooting 32%.
Well, he is erratic because he's got a very flat release, and he gets his legs split often, as I've already mentioned. And sometimes I think he's shooting a little early. I know that's Iona's style, but there are other better shooters on his team that probably need to get more looks.
12 seconds on the shot clock as Mosley gets to the free throw line. Kick out to Bryant, didn't catch it cleanly, so puts it on the floor, fades, didn't square up to the rim, leaning to the left side, and missed to the left on that shot. Cassell wants to push, Crawford on the run. Pinkard's there, blocks the shot, hanging with him, ball's on the floor. Two big guys, Leslin for it, and Washington comes up with it, puts it up off the window and in.
And that's where Delaware's going to get on the floor. The great ones are the first of the four, the teams that are really aggressive. You're not going to try to outfight a senior that's 6'8", 235. You've got to get down there and secure the ball. Possession is worth a point.
And right there, 2 points as Washington got it up and in. And now Delaware with a two-point lead again, 27-25. Washington, 12 points for Iona here in the first half in limited minutes. He hasn't even played that much for Iona. Mosey traveled with it after getting a pass on the top of the key from Daly. So a turnover for the Hens. Their sixth turnover of the game compared to three for Iona, who we mentioned take care of the basketball very well.
It's very interesting, isn't it? For a team that pushes it, they're very good in terms of what we call valuing the ball. They value each possession because they want to get up the three-point shots, but they have very skilled players. I'm really impressed with McGill's basketball IQ. Cassell is an excellent ball handler. Crawford, Sevier, all of them handle the ball quite well. They're very skilled. They spend a lot of time, obviously, passing and pushing the ball, but it just gives them more open possessions versus turnovers, which are empty possessions.
Washington spins into what is a double team by Pinkard, but Pinkard, in doing so, fouled him. That's a foul on the senior Duvon, and it is the sixth foul on Delaware, so no free throws coming up for Iona.
It's clear that Jordan Washington loves to attack when he does via the dribble and spin. That's the second time. You've got to be there, be low, and have your hands at where the ball's being dribbled, not up, and that's what created the foul there by Duvon.
Second foul on Pinkard. Two for Pinkard, two for Harris for Delaware. Svanderlick into the game. He's got it right side over Sevier, left. Straightening out is Much, center circle. Brings it to the right side with 20 to shoot, 2:07 to play. And Delaware with a two-point lead, 27-25. Washington, one dribble, two. Now he drives, blocking foul called against Eric Carter. That's his second now. And I'll tell you, Jordan Washington is hard to stop, both on the glass and when he gets the ball in his hand.
He is. He's a very capable ball handler himself when he dribbles. He's got excellent body control. But what I like about him is at 6'8", he's got a great first step. That means when he puts it down on the floor, he is gaining space towards or ground towards the basket. And his spin move is so explosive. So he's got a couple different variations upon theme of attacking the basket, beside being a good back-to-the-basket, low-post offensive player.
With the second foul on Carter, we see Sky Johnson check in for the very first time. Johnson, Cushing, Bryant, Daly, and Hayes on the floor. As Washington makes his first.
And for a big man, I like Jordan Washington's free throw stroke as well. He knows he's going to get fouled a lot. He shoots 71% on the season. That's pretty good for a physical big man.
He misses the second after making the first, though, with 71%. I'll take that all day for a guy that's 6'8", 235 out of Jamaica, New York. 27-26. Hens holding on to a one-point lead here in the first half as Cushing is double-teamed. In the corner, it goes to Hayes. Hayes picks up his dribble, goes to the corner. Now it's Johnson. Left block, working on Washington. To his right-handed hook shot, missing strong, and a rebound by Washington. That's his fourth. On the run, Sevier. No one stopped him as he gets into the paint. Kick out, knocked away by Hayes. Ball on the floor. Bryant's ahead of the pack. Clear path to the rim, and he slams it with a right hand.
A great job by Darian Bryant, who I think has played one of his best games of the year, not only from an energy standpoint of being able to stay out there because of that back condition. He's been a very willing passer, and he always seems to be around the ball when we need him most.
Nice job by Kasman to get his hands on that basketball to start what was the breakaway dunk by Darian Bryant. I agree with you, though. Very impressed by Darian Bryant this half. Screen and roll inside to Washington. He misses for just the third time today. 5 of 8 from the field. He's slow to get up. Delaware has 5-on-4. And it's a turnover. And as Washington didn't get back after the steal, he's cherry-picking on the other side of the floor. A timeout by Inglesby after the basket by Washington. That did not work out well. It turned out it was a 5-on-4 for Delaware, and then the turnover allowed to be 1-on-none for Iona.
And that's where you need to be so circumspect in how you attack. Yes, they're short a man. The big guy had fallen down. He was looking for a foul and kind of bemoaning that fact instead of hustling back. But now what you want to do against numbers is drive the ball. You don't want to try to skip pass it across where they may be already distributed. Drive the ball against their deployment, and then you're going to find somebody open, obviously, because they only have four defenders back. Just a bad play by us because we tried to play too fast.
It's a seventh turnover by Delaware in this half, and it leads to a breakaway point by Washington. He's got 15 of Iona's 28 in just 12 minutes of action. We knew how good this guy would be by just looking at some stats and reading up on him, but to see him in person, this is a guy that's going to be a first-team All-MAAC this season. That's for sure, at least if he continues at this pace. Very impressed by him, but despite all the work he's done, Iona still down by one, 29-28. It's Delaware basketball with 47.9 on the first half clock as Darian Bryant will inbound, and it goes to Kasman Hayes.
Iona still has not really been tough defensively. They're playing this matchup zone. It has some man principles into it. Now they do a little bit of pressure to try to create our speed-up situation by us. We could have played two for one, but now we're not going to. We'll just settle for a really good shot here as the clock runs down.
11 to shoot for Delaware. Kasman Hayes beyond the arc, brings it to the right side, picks up his dribble. Mosley sees the seam, flips it to Bryant. What a look by Anthony Mosley.
Being able to drive into these gaps, which is available against this Iona matchup, has been really a smart decision. Mosley with a great find to Bryant, who continues to impress me with his effective and efficient play here tonight.
7 seconds for Iona, down by three. Now four, Cassell. Three-point shot, no good. Rebound, Daly. That's how it'll end the first 20 minutes of basketball. Delaware on top, 31-28. A lot to be impressed about on their home floor tonight for the Hens.
I love the tempo of the game. It's played at exactly the same the pace that Martin Inglesby wanted. We've done a good job defending the defensive glass. We've got to come up with a little bit of an answer for the big man Washington, but a lot of it has just been great play by him. I think we have shared the ball and some really outstanding play by Darian Bryant and Anthony Mosley.
Control tempo. That's something Martin Inglesby has said in the pregame interviews with us throughout the year. This time, Delaware making sure it has happened in the first half. 31-28 as we head to halftime. Benny Pinella is back in the WDSD studios. He's got the Blue Hens halftime report presented by the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local 313, and their local contractors. We'll step aside when we come back. Scores from around college basketball, CAA scores, and of course some news and notes from Blue Hens Athletics. Back in a moment as Delaware leads by three at the half, 31-28 over Iona. Kazmir, and then just three from E.J. Crawford on 1-of-4 shooting, and two from Deshaun Mutz that came early. Nobody else has done anything as far as scoring for Iona. Delaware get the basketball first. They'll shoot going right to left as we see it across from the Delaware home bench, and we are back in action here in the second half. Delaware, a three-point lead. Starters on the floor. Bryant, Pinkard, Mosley, Daly, and Harris to start against this Iona defense.
And Iona opening up in a man. They played more of a matchup with a lot of switching in the first half. Here they're trying to get out and force Delaware to play a little bit faster.
Mosley kick out from the baseline out to Pinkard on the wing right side. He misses on a three, and a rebound by Iona. McGill down the floor to Washington, who dribbled along the baseline, turned it over. The pass was a little too far, leading Washington ahead. He couldn't grip it.
Well, Darian Bryant did a great job of getting back very quickly because Washington had challenged the shot and had leaked out. He was open down the court.
Now Daly for Harris at the free throw line. He turns, wants to find a guard, gets it to Bryant. Delaware with three guys that have played point guard at some point in time during the season on the floor together in Bryant, Daly, and Mosley.
Now Delaware's getting organized here in a set play, a little bit of motion off some down screens.
Daly on the wing to the free throw line, the running. Shot is good from Ryan Daly. Used the right hand to get it to go.
Absolutely. No opposition in the middle of the lane by Iona. They almost don't even really want to contest any shots in there. Let Delaware shoot it and then attack.
Double team comes on Washington as Pinkard comes over to help. He forces a shot in the reverse. Wanted a foul. Didn't get one. Didn't deserve one. Not contact on the shot.
Well, Washington definitely begging for that. He's got to be careful. He's already got one technical, one more, and he'd be out of the game.
Pinkard long on what was a two-point shot. Daly running for the ball, saving it in front of his Delaware teammates on the bench.
A great job by Daly recognizing how long that shot was going to be missed to and doing a great job of saving it to the only person he could, his teammate Anthony Mosley up top.
Mosley stands at 15 to shoot. Iona daring him to shoot, but Mosley wise enough to run the offense. 10 to shoot. Here's Mosley now to the free throw line, just above the free throw line. He misses. Harris, an offensive rebound. Gets his footing down along the baseline and brings it back out. Third try on this possession for Delaware after two offensive boards. Daly spinning left to Harris. An elbow jumper left side is no good, and finally a defensive rebound for the Gale.
Good job by Daly creating some space there for Barnett Harris by driving in with a nice reverse pivot.
Inside Crawford, a blocking foul on Harris as the ball goes through, chance for three.
And the reason that's called, Scott, is because Barnett unfortunately could not get outside the arc. He was underneath the basket too far. It was definitely a charge because he ran right into Barnett. Injured player on the floor as well. Believe it's Washington.
It looks like Washington. Washington slow to get up. He was in the mix as he's down with 17:56 left to go. That would be a huge blow for Iona if he can't return because he was more than half of the offense in the first half, 15 points in his first 12 minutes in that first half.
I'm hoping for him this is not orthopedic, more just a hard hit of the knee, a little trauma to the kneecap as he went down. What I loved there was Barnett's great hustle at the offensive end, secured the offensive rebound, brought it back out. He was wide open at the foul line, a shot that I know was fine for him to take because I've seen him make that a lot. And then he sprints back down on defense, gets himself in perfect position. But in college, unlike high school and much like the pros, there's an arc there around the basket that if you're inside that, even if you do take the man right into your chest, it's going to be called against you. So a good call by the official because of Barnett's positioning, not because of his effort.
And the foul does go against Delaware, third on Harris. Harris will go to the bench because of that. Carter comes in, and Washington getting checked out by the trainer Sam DeRosa on the bench there.
I saw in your notes, Scott, that Sam DeRosa, the trainer from Iona, 26 years at the same place.
Season.
That's very impressive.
We were chatting with the training and strength and conditioning team here at Delaware, who does a fine job. Prior to this game getting started. Trying to get these guys to be able to stay on the floor for a longer period of time. A lot of injuries this year for Delaware, although short term, like Chavarsky, if you're just tuning in for the first time, out today with a knee injury.
And here's this harassment press, a little bit of what we call a 3-2, but it's just designed to slow Delaware up. which or speed them up in the sense of taking a shot a little bit quicker and then back to man. This is something they've shown most of the game.
Free throw was no good from Iona. Delaware, the three-point lead, 33-30. Daly, catch, shoot, three, contested. Not a good look from Daly. He missed, rebounded by Delaware. Pass deflected as it was saved along the baseline. Bryant got it back momentarily, knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Much, and now Much seems to be in some pain. He gets picked up. That's the second time I've seen Much rolling around on the floor looking for attention.
Much is wearing a knee brace on his right knee. He's also hit the floor, as you described, twice, and he gets himself a little out of control, but that was a hustle play there, trying to be the first guy to the floor to secure the defensive rebound.
33-30, Delaware with the basketball and the lead. Bryant on a cut inside the paint, just gets it over McGill and in.
Bad defense by Iona. They trailed every screen there, and that time Bryant quickly and intelligently cut towards the basket.
A three on the other side. Much rattles it in from the wing.
Long-range three early in the possession. That is Iona basketball, and here they follow with this 2-1-2 press now, which has some man, and they'll fall back into man.
35-33, Delaware's lead. 16-50, first half, as Mosley runs the offense. Pinkert goes in motion. Foul line, it's Bryant. One dribble, jumper, around and out.
It's a shame. That was good offense there by Delaware. Mosley did a good job of recognizing Bryant, read the back screen perfectly, and had a wide open 10-foot shot.
Much tries again from three. Back iron, rebounded by Daly. He's got seven. He's second on the team with six rebounds per game, and he's got six-plus rebounds and now seven of the last eight contests.
He does that because he's well-positioned, but most importantly because he's always fighting and a relentless rebounder.
Another floater this time, baseline right side. Quick shot from Daly that time.
Quick shot, but also a tough shot along the baseline. No backboard to be able to use. That floater can be very inconsistent at times.
Much again from three. Strong again. Bessick can't control the rebound. Poked away, out of bounds. It'll stay. With Iona, last touch by Delaware. Gales basketball with a chance to tie or take the lead when we return. 15:58 left from the Bob Carpenter Center as Delaware leads 35-33. Welcome back to the Bob Carpenter Center, where Delaware leads 35-33, 15:58 left to go. Join us for the next Blue Hens Basketball Coaches Show presented by First State Orthopedics. It's live from Klondike Kate's on Main Street. The next show can be heard from 7 to 8 o'clock on January 3rd. That's Tuesday, starting off 2017 with myself, Coach Inglesby, Coach Tina Martin, and Matt Janis, the voice of the women's basketball team at Kate's. Enjoy dinner and watch us and listen to the Blue Hens Basketball Coaches Show on 94.7 WDSD. Join us on Tuesday, January 3rd. Back in action, Sam Cassell in the basketball game for the first time in the second half. He's got the basketball over to Sevier, who's been quiet. No points in 15 minutes for the grad transfer from Fordham, who averages over 12 points a game. Cassell on the dribble drive gets past everybody. Well, not Kasman Hayes, as he came over to help and block the shot.
The easiest place and the best place to block shots is from the rotation from the weak side as the second blocker, and Kasman did a great job of recognizing that and thwarting Cassell's drive.
Sevier, a turnover. He jab-stepped on Hayes, who's playing stellar defense tonight, and turned it over on a traveling violation.
Well, I've always loved Kasman's defense, Scott. He stays down in his stance. He plays very hard. He's got a good feel for the angles, and he does a great job of consuming the scouting report.
With Hayes in, Mosley getting a breather, so Bryant and Daly going up against this pressure to bring the ball up the floor. They get across half court. Pinkert In the corner left side, brings it back out to the wing. Hayes guarded by Crawford closely. Back to Pinkert. Catches it low. Brings it up. Missing on the three. Weak side rebound. Dele, he was grabbed before the shot went up, I believe. Foul on the floor against Iona. And that's going to be the first on the Gales.
Iona back into their true zone. They're a 2-3. But it actually has aspects of a matchup because the bottom player, Taylor Besick, did not even come out to the corner. So that was a contest from the high side by Kazmir. Pinkert wide open. Great positioning on the weak side by Ryan Dele to secure the offensive rebound.
Dele catches it off the inbound. Reset shot clock. Hayes in the corner on top to Bryan, who's played very well. Hayes to Dele. Baseline drive left. Pass to Bryan in the corner. Good looking three-point shooter. He knocks it down in front of the Delaware bench.
Nice pass through by Dele as the attack left to right along the baseline. Iona allowed him to get there and throw a left-handed pass. Perfectly delivered to Darian Bryan, who rose up in rhythm.
Now a foul away from the ball against Iona's Sam Cassell. Offensive foul, turnover. Delaware gets the basketball after the three made by Darian Bryan. Bryan now 9 of 18 from three-point range. Reminds me of last year's stat line from Anthony Mosley. Didn't shoot a lot of threes, but shot when he was open. And they went in because they were good-looking shots.
That Bryant, was a though, pick there by Munch, who just picked a crossover by Bryan.
Inbound went to Bryant. Munch took it away and was able to score off of the turnover. So a turnover by Cassell gave it to Delaware, and the steal gives Iona the basketball back, and a layup is good. Hayes gets it across half court to Pinkert. Pinkert trapped between two Iona players in half court. He loses grip, and now Kazmir ahead, stepped out of bounds on the sideline. He was trying to tiptoe as he stole it away, but Delaware all of a sudden getting sloppy, and Anthony Mosley going to check back in.
Just not being organized against the press. Iona's quite long, and they play it enough so they have a good feel for their angles. That time Devon got the ball right at midcourt on the timeline. He was very fortunate he didn't get called for backcourt. And then as he dribbled, the ball just got away from him. Very fortunate there that it did go out of bounds. Delaware possession at half court.
Kazmin going to inbound right in front of us. Very impressed with Kazmin's new haircut. Whoever the barber is that Kazmin Hayes has, props to him. He's looking sharp. He's about 2 feet away from us. Got a good look at it. I don't know if that will affect his game, but it certainly has helped his defense, I think, today.
Scotty, Jordan Washington has checked back in, too, so that knee looks like it's okay now.
Washington was hurt earlier in this half. But you're right, back into the ball game, and what a difference maker he is for Iona. Mosley, right block, working on Kazmir. That's two point guards going at it in the block, and a shot clock violation is going to be the call as Mosley's shot did not hit the rim. I thought Iona had secured possession, and they could have continued play, but they stopped play to call the shot clock violation.
Well, Washington did a nice job there of not only contesting the shot, making his presence known very quickly, but securing the rebound.
14:05, second half. Delaware up by three. They've led by as many as eight, five in this half. But they've made just two of their last 10, have the Hens on offense. Munch has played well in the second half. He drives Carter with the block. Ball goes out of bounds. It'll stay with Iona.
Kazman did a nice job there of kind of leveling Munch off so he didn't get a straight line opportunity to the basket. And then Eric Carter rotating from that weak side.
Washington, a couple of jabs. The jumper dies on the back iron and gets into the hands of Mosley after the miss.
Good job by Mosley, one of the better rebounding guards in the country, especially at the defensive end. Does a great job of being explosive and with good position.
Ends up by three, 38-35. Dele after the screen by Carter. Gets it to Carter. Carter right block working on Washington. One dribble, two. Here comes Kazmir. Into the corner, Mosley to Hayes with seven. Hayes, foul line, into the paint. Gets body contact, no whistle. Washington, good defense that time for the 6'8 senior.
Washington was just vertically perfect there and did not step in.
No one stopped Cassell. He got inside the paint, kicked it out. It ended up with a three-pointer from Kazmir. He missed, though. Dele on the run. He'll wait for his teammates. Sees an opening, though. Gets to the foul line, picks up his dribble, send it back out to Hayes. Delaware up by three, 7 minutes into the second half. 38-35, Mosley back to Kazmin Hayes. Hayes, the senior, came off the bench today. And now it's Carter. Left block, nine to shoot. Working on Washington. To his right hand, short. Dele an offensive board. Contact, and he'll go to the free throw line. That's just Dele being aware of the shot coming out of Carter's hands and in a good position on the offensive box out.
Sometimes the best offensive rebound comes off of an air ball. Eric Carter got bodied away there by Washington, who did a great job of forcing him away from the basket. Eric needs to get on balance on that shot or maybe shot fake Washington. But Dele, who kind of has that unique position of where he can play a forward, somebody taller than him, but many times gets a shorter defender on him. They're not used to being inside as much. He gravitates in there. He gets himself in great position, and these people refuse to block him out. He's very physical, and he has a great feel for getting himself in exactly the right position to secure the rebound. That's just intrinsic. That's not something he's necessarily taught.
Daly makes the second after missing the first. Not a good free throw shooter, at least at this point in his career, only 56% coming into this one. Cassell Jr. trying to go quickly, gets up the floor to the free to the free throw line, stopped by Carter there and brings it back out with 21 to shoot. Iona wants to go fast, has not been able to do so this game. Nice job.
That's a great point, Scott. They're running a little bit of weave here just to get themselves moving around, reversing the ball so they can dump it into Washington.
Washington flips it from the left block to the right wing in Cassell. Cassell loses his footing, but gets to McGill. McGill on the dribble drive. He gets tripped up, and a traveling violation is the call. Stellar Delaware defense, the eighth turnover for the Gaels.
Boy, that was a break for Delaware. I wasn't sure that Daly didn't actually initiate that trip with some contact, but I believe that's Timmy Ryan made that call from across the court. Good vision on that by the lead official tonight.
Delaware with some pressure as Iona. Full court pickup. Mosley gets across half court. Ball poked away by McGill, but contact there. That's the fourth on the Gaels with 12-12 left.
That's a maneuver I describe the players as the dart move. That's where the defender looks like they're going to stay on one side, and they literally just dart in front of you to try to create the turnover. That time, I believe Mosley did a great job of just staying on his path and hit him with his inside hip, but a pretty cagey play there by the sophomore Ricky McGill from Iona.
And Iona does have five steals. It has worked reaching for the ball. They took one away from Bryant earlier the half. Not that time, though. Mosley left alone. They'll let him shoot if he wants to, but he'll find Pickard instead, and another offensive foul on a screen. Countless amount of times.
And that's Eric Carter just not allowing Pickard to use his screen. As a screener, you have to be set. You've got to establish your position and then not move any body part. Unfortunately, I think it was a pretty good call there because I saw him slide his hips. He's got to let Pinkard use the screen and stay stationary.
It's a turnover. That's the third foul on Carter, and just illegal screens this season. Too many per game for the Hens. Much to McGill. Delaware up by four, 39-35, under 12. Cassell, the three right wing, around and out. Kasman Hayes, a rebound, almost poked away by McGill, but Hayes secures it to Anthony Mosley.
Oh, Delaware's a little fortunate there. Cassell was wide open, but that shot continues to come out of his hand a little flat. Results in the miss and a good rebound by Kasman.
Hayes on the other end of three. No one boxes out. Daly puts it back up and in.
Well, the assignment was John Sevier, and he did absolutely nothing to thwart Daly's attempt to go to the basket. He's got to put a body on him. That's going to be something for the film when Coach Tim Kloos gets back.
Daly's got a new career high 11 rebounds thus far. Much of three. No good. Make it 12 for Ryan Daly, who continues to have an outstanding rookie campaign.
Scott, that shot there by Munch was A.J. English range.
A.J. English last year played well against Iona. We know he has the against Delaware for Iona. He had the green light a season ago. Daly, bright green for Delaware this year. He leans into one and scores again.
Delaware taking advantage of the matchup there with Daly being guarded by Ricky McGill, who's not used to playing players inside the post. A good job there identifying the matchup and taking advantage of it was Ryan Daly.
Hens have tied their largest lead of the night, 43-35. Sevier baseline. He stepped on the baseline. Delaware forces a turnover, and Iona gets a much-needed timeout. It's the media break with 10:24 remaining, and the Hens up 43-35. largest lead of the night. They led by 8 with 14 minutes left in the first half. Now, 10:24 left in this one, and a 43-35 advantage. I'm Scott Klatskin alongside Bill Harmon. Delaware trying to get their first ever win over Iona. Iona leads the all-time series 5-0. And Ryan Daly, his first career double-double, 10 points, 12 rebounds in 28 minutes of action.
He's gotten himself in great position inside. He's been guarded by McGill. He's been guarded by Kazmir at 5'10", Sevier at 6'2", McGill at 6'1". So he's been able to take advantage of the shorter players on him. I think that's an adjustment that the associate head coach Grasso's got to make.
Mosley into the body of Washington again. Mosley finds a way to get his shot off above a taller shot blocker. And it goes in.
It's amazing to me, Scott, how often opponents allow Mosley to attack by his left hand because he scores so much more consistently there. Now, he can score from the right side, but he's just uncanny in his ability to decipher exactly where to shoot the ball on that shot.
Hens on a 7-0 run. Washington trying to end it. Double clutches and misses. He's scoreless in the second half after 15 in the first.
Barnett did a great job. Barnett Harris did, of staying between Washington in the basket, but also those long arms of Barnett influenced Washington, who thought he got fouled.
Hayes, corner three, off the mark. Bryant crashing in. He knocked it out of bounds, but loved the effort from the transfer from George Washington.
Darren Bryant, one of the best places to rebound from is from that elbow position. He recognized Kazman's shot was a little flat, was going long, almost got himself a great rebound on the weak side.
Hens on a 7-0 run for the second time in this game, had a 7-0 run in the first half as well. Cassell with the basketball. Iona matched that 7-0 run with a 7-0 run of their own in the first half. See what they can get going offensively. Crawford shot over Harris, who came down a little too hard on the shot block attempt, and in doing so, hit the shooter. Crawford, I think if he stayed straight up, he would have gotten the block cleanly.
There's no question about that. After playing great defense on Washington, where Barnett was stationary, just that little movement kind of forced Barnett to get a little too aggressive. And as you mentioned, his left arm came right down to try to block the shot. Be vertical, maybe tip the ball at the top of the release, and maybe get the rebound, affect the shot, and clearly not get the foul.
Foul on Harris is his third. Crawford at the free throw line makes the first. Crawford's got 7 points now. Double figures in 7 of 12 games this season for Crawford. Misses the second. Harris secures the rebound for Delaware, but that free throw ended a 7-0 run for the Hens. Iona still 0 of their last 6 from the field.
Iona still trying to be very feisty here with this three-quarter court harassment press. They come back down and they're playing some man, a little bit of a matchup here, I think. Just trying to force Delaware into making some difficult decisions here against this pressure.
9 minutes left. Harris, baseline right. Jabs on Washington, gets it stripped. That's good recognition by McGill to come over and take it away from someone that's not comfortable dribbling the basketball. Knocked out of bounds by Hayes on the other end. It'll stay with Iona.
McGill is very quick. He's got excellent hands, and he's got a long reach, and he's always in around the level of where the ball's being dribbled. A lot of players play too high, and he plays right at the level where the ball is going to be.
6 steals for Iona, 10 turnovers for Delaware. Kazmir, he'll try from three, and he misses short right side. Nobody in maroon there to rebound for Iona.
Well, Washington was on the other side. The shot was missed short, but that Delaware going back into a little bit of a zone there, a 2-3, and afforded the long-range shot by Kazmir to miss.
Timeout taken by Delaware with 8:30 remaining. We'll take a break with them. 45-36, Delaware on top over the Gales. that's our score. Let's get some other scores around the CAA. Penn improved to 5-5 on the season with a win at home against Drexel, 75-67 right now. Clemson out of the ACC, 9-2 on the year, having a good season, 63-44. They're up on UNCW. And James Madison playing that tough non-conference slate against East Mennonite. They are 1-11 on the season. Are the Dukes up 59-50. They just went on a 4-0 run. And Elon up 28-17 over Central Pennsylvania. JMU struggling this year. I love to see it, though. I'm jealous of their football team, the success they're having. So at least they can take it out on the basketball team. As we get back in action, and Mosley turns it over, looking inside to Barnett here.
We tried to pass off the dribble there instead of jump-stopping. The pass was should have been a bounce pass. It was an air pass and good hands there by Iona's defense.
Kazmir to Severe, who has been silent tonight. Gets it to Crawford on the handoff. He thought about a three, but Bryant was there. Kazmir passed back to Crawford. Bryant there again. Euro step by Crawford. He took about two trips around Europe and then came back to the United States traveling on that play, and it goes back to the head.
That was an Asian walk.
Yeah, that was
Asia
something
walk.
From another continent.
Anyway,
that's for
Crawford
sure.
Just playing way too fast. He had a couple shots that he passed up. Plus, he had Bryant up in the air. He probably should have just tried to draw the foul.
The turnover by Iona takes us to another timeout, though. 7:46 left to go. 45-36 the score. Delaware on top of Iona. Back in a moment on 94.7 WDSD.
My hammer pants. I've got to return the sports bloopers VHS before we hit up Fuddruckers.
This is not an inspired effort here by
some
Iona.
Things never come out of style. Like the delicious taste of Fuddruckers with 100% all natural, fresh, never frozen premium beef patties, fresh baked buns, and our build your own topping bar. Great taste is always in at Fuddruckers.
UD students and faculty, present your ID card and receive 15% off at our Newark location.
Radical. Fuds is forever.
Fuddruckers, the world's greatest hamburger.
People's Plaza, the place to eat, shop, and more is your one-stop tax-free shopping destination with plenty of free parking. With over 83 retailers, restaurants, specialty shops, and professional services, People's Plaza has everything you need in one location. People's Plaza is minutes from Maryland, Wilmington, and Pennsylvania. Located in Glasgow near the intersection of Routes 40 and 896. People's Plaza, eat, shop, and more. They do have it all. Also online at peoplesplaza.com.
You are listening to UD Men's Basketball.
Delaware leads 45-36, 7:46 left to go. We talked with Coach Inglesby pregame about the three-point shooting threat that Iona gives Delaware, the Hens holding them from beyond the arc.
You're right. They have shot 4 for 20. That's 20% by my calculations. They're a 36% three-point shooting team on the season. A lot of their looks have been, I think, forced and from long range. Delaware doing a pretty good job of closing out but identifying when these shots are ill-advised and doing a good job of running down the long rebounds.
10 to shoot for Delaware. Inside to Harris, working on Besick. Draws the foul. Does Barnett Harris on Taylor Besick, the transfer from James Madison, and Harris will go to the free throw line where he's 4 of 6 on the year.
What a great set call by Coach Martin Inglesby out of the timeout. Barnett posting up with a weak side duck in. Devon Pinker delivering the ball at exactly the right time. Barnett working hard to his right shoulder and his left arm, and a foul there by Taylor Besick. Barnett really showing some great aggressiveness inside tonight.
Harris from the free throw line makes that one good. He's got his first point of the game, 9 on the season, but any offense that he provides, any scoring he provides, is a bonus. You look at only 8 points on the season, but that's not what he's there for. The energy, the defensive presence, the rebounding ability, that's what he provides. And second free throw coming up from Harris. Back iron does not go in, and Washington grabs the rebound. But Delaware up by 10.
This is a margin here that Iona's got to cut into pretty quickly. Now, they have the explosiveness to do it. They're still continuing to run this weave. Delaware's done a pretty good job of switching it.
Cassell from the free throw line. Good.
Now, Cassell looks to me like he's a much better shooter off the dribble, where he can recruit his legs underneath him than the spot. That time, a nice little left-to-right dribble off the bounce, scores with a beautiful-looking shot, just like his father
used to.
Yeah,
his father. 15 seasons in the NBA. 3-time NBA champion, Sam Cassell. Same name as his dad, Daly, to the rim.
No shot block protection with Washington lifted high with Barnett Harris. A great drive by Daly with his right hand.
Hens back up 10, 48-38, 6:35 to go. And Ryan Daly, 12 points, 12 rebounds for the rookie. Washington on the drive, offensive, too aggressive. Woods, Jordan Washington, who has not scored in the second half, it'll stay that way.
Washington trying to kind of push the pace here. He's getting a little frustrated. Barnett did a great job of staying in front of him there, got outside the arc to draw the charge. But what I like about Washington, when he knocked Barnett down, he did a nice job there, sportsman-wise, of helping pick Barnett up off the floor.
And I thought you picked the correct word to describe that, frustrating. I think Barnett Harris has frustrated Washington in the second half.
There's no question he has. He's long, he's active, and he's not allowing Washington to get into any kind of rhythm.
Daly, a pass to the cutting Mosley, who lost grip. Much with the steal. Ahead to Kazmir. Bryant back on defense. Kazmir lost it. Finds his teammate Much in the corner, and a timeout taken by associate coach Jared Grasso, who is head coach today for the absent Tim Clues. We'll stay right here with 6:11 remaining, and Delaware up 48-38. Nice job by Delaware to get back on defense, or at least by Bryant, helped out by a loss of dribble by Iona.
That was one of the keys in the pregame show, and also talking to Martin and a couple of the assistants before the game, is not allow Iona to get any easy baskets. Delaware's defense is obviously the clarion call here this evening, only allowing 38 points here with 6:11 left. This is a team that averages 76 and can put 90 up on the board extremely easily. They want to play in a rhythm and a flow. Delaware's kind of frustrated them, using the shot clock to their advantage, getting a lot of good possessions offensively, reversing the ball, and then defensively not allowing them to get anywhere they want. And I think that's been it. Cutting off the driving lanes, doing a much better job in the second half of not allowing Jordan Washington any easy baskets, and benefiting a little bit from a cold shooting night from the outside. But let's partly credit Delaware's three-point defense for that.
And you mentioned the cold shooting, but Delaware with a comfortable 10-point lead, or a solid 10-point lead, I would say. They shouldn't get comfortable, because Iona, as we talked about, has the firepower. This Iona team, just a season ago, some different personnel members, but the type of offense remains the same. 92 points against Delaware last year. If they get going, they can score in bunches. So Delaware has to continue playing well against an Iona team, as you said, 76 points per game on the year. It'll be Iona basketball after the timeout, down by 10, 6:11 to go at the Bob Carpenter Center. Hens looking to go 5-0 to start the year at home for the first time since 99-2000. McGill, close to a five-second call, gets it to Much. Between the circles, between the leg dribble, inside out, now a quick crossover, Much. Back to Crawford, left open for a three, squares, fires too strong. Daly on the rise, knocks it to Harris, who tracks it down.
And there's a good job by Delaware defending their glass. That shot was in that 50-50 area. Both Daly and Barnett Harris went for it. Barnett runs it down eventually in the corner, but good blocking out, good physical rebounding by Delaware here tonight.
Iona just 1 of 8, that's 12% in the second half from long range, 19%. On the game, 4 of 21. 8 to shoot for Daly. Spinning into traffic. Mosley to Pinkert. 5 to shoot. Straight away. One dribble. A 3 off balance off the mark. And a rebound by Crawford for Iona. McGill looking to push. Head up. Bryant picks him up. 25 to shoot. 5:23 to play. Much on the wing. He gets past Pinkert. And a hand check is going to be called as Pinkert reached out as the penetration got past him.
Well, Delaware has two more fouls to give here. That's not a bad one. We want to keep Iona out of the lane where they can get those crackbacks, where the offensive player whose teammate is being driven into the lane, he cracks back. He rises up from the outside to get himself a wide open shot up top. Delaware's done a good job of defending that. Plus, they've done a good job with these exterior picks where they've switched them or doubled them.
Fourth foul on Pinkert a moment ago, so he'll check out. Hayes, Daly, Carter, Johnson, Bryant, and Mosley. Steal by Daly. Daly on the run, gets it to go.
Well, Daly is fearless. He attacks a taller player, finishes over top him. He's got a great feel for keeping his body away, creating some space, and then using the backboard to soften up the shot.
14 for Daly now. Again, first career double-double. He has 12 rebounds. McGill brings it back out to Cassell Jr. They'll have a catch. McGill with it now. Flips it to Much. Much. NBA range three. Too strong. Mosley with a rebound around the three-point arc. He bumped into Daly. Daly smiles and gives him a pat on the back.
That's the definition of settling there. Much was at least 6 feet beyond the arc there to shoot that shot. He's off balance. He did not have his legs under him because he was so far out.
If Tim Clues is watching this stream at home, and we hope he feels better, he's yelling at the screen right now on that shot selection by Much. 50-38 is the score. 12-point lead is the largest by Delaware. Mosley to the rim, gets it up. Shot partially blocked. Shot clock violation for the second time tonight by Delaware.
But in a certain way, Scott, that's okay. They got a look. It wasn't a great one. But again, the extension of the shot clock, running it down, making Iona defend, and also just keeping them out of their rhythm. I think the strategy has been great, and so has the execution tonight.
Kazmir with the basketball for Iona. Pass to Cassell Jr. Crawford fakes a pass, dribble drive inside, poked away, but a foul is going to be called against Delaware. Anthony Mosley calling for the foul. It's Delaware's fifth first-time champ, and we'll take a timeout. Final media timeout of the ball game. We'll see if Delaware can hold on for the final 3:59. 50-38 is their lead over Iona. The Bob Carpenter Center. Delaware has not started off 5-0 at home since the 1999-2000 season, when Delaware won its first nine games at home. Delaware a chance to do just that if they can hold on to a 12-point advantage, 50-38, just under 4 minutes left at the Bob. I'm Scott Clapton alongside Bill Harmon. Iona with the basketball. They have made just one of their last 10 from the field. McGill triggers it in, reset shot clock to Kazmir on the wing. Mosley called for his first foul as we went to break. Cassell, pass to Washington. He traveled with the basketball. He knew the double team was coming, tried to move too quickly, and turned it over.
Well, Brian did a great job of recognizing that Washington was going to spin to his left shoulder on that side to his left. He went underneath instead of coming over top to double, and I think that had something to do with creating the turnover.
Full court pressure by Iona. They get it into Mosley. Mosley back to Dale, and he'll be able to walk it up.
Delaware has shown good patience for the most part against the press. They've gotten into their sets. They've been running them very efficiently here in the second half. They've had a good shot almost every time down.
3:30 to go. 10 to shoot for Mosley on the wing. Carter trying to get possession inside. They go to him. Left block, pass out to Hayes. Hayes, catch, shoot, three, good.
Not only was that beautifully timed by Kazmir Hayes, was with only 3 seconds remaining on the shot clock.
Excellent possession. Severe three. Gets a triple right back. That's his first made shot, and a timeout by Iona. 1 of 4 for Severe. You look at the defensive statistics for Delaware. We've talked about three-point defense holding Iona to 5 of 23, 4 of 22 before that make. But you look at individual defense. No points for Washington in the second half. You've got John Severe, who averages 12 points per game, second most on the team. That was his first bucket. You've got Sam Cassell Jr., who averages 11 points per game, third best on the team. He's 1 of 6 with 2 points, his first basket coming a few minutes ago at the foul line. Solid individual defense in today's game.
Done a great job of staying in front of them, limiting their shots, And also, the player that I think can be explosive for them, Ricky McGill, 0 points on only 2 shots. So Delaware really doing a good job collectively as well as individually, as you described. I think they've done a good job of shutting off driving lanes, staying in front, making them shoot over top. It was clear early on Iona was going to take some bad shots, and Delaware's rebounded the ball well.
Bryant throws it into Pinker after the timeout taken by Iona. They'll have one timeout left, Delaware with 2 timeouts. Hens 5 seconds to get across the timer, and Pinker did just that with an array of spin moves. And he gets it to Mosley. Mosley will have 18 to work as he goes to Hayes. Hayes much better tonight than he played against USF, scoring only 2 points last time out against the Bulls. 10 to shoot. Bryant back deep left side. 7 now. Screen comes from Pickard. Brings it straight away. Pass to Daly. He called for it. 3 on the way. Back to back. Triples by Delaware. And they increase their lead.
And a great job by Darian Bryant finding Ryan Daly off pin down. Kazmir was nowhere close. Just bad defense there by the sophomore.
Severe, though. Back-to-back threes himself. Another answer again from the left side.
Delaware just needs to take their time, stay organized against the press, clear out, keep the ball in the middle of the floor.
This execution by Delaware has been just phenomenal. They have played the game they wanted to play. As I say that, Bryant, out of where he is on the floor, stepped on the half-court line and turned it over.
Just too much dribbling. You never want to retreat when you're that close. Just pick the ball up. We've got possession. Plus, we have timeouts available to use as well.
2:11 remaining. Delaware up by 12 against Iona, a team that averages 76 points per game. They've got 44 in this one. Pass to Sevier is out of bounds. Miscommunication by McGill and Sevier, and Delaware gets the ball right back.
There's an example of why you never want to fake backdoor. Mm-hmm. Sevier came out. It was definitely a backdoor opportunity. He kind of head faked it, and it was read as a backdoor. McGill threw it there, and just nobody there. So good defense again by Delaware, extending and being smart.
Bryant to Hayes. Hayes attacking, has to slow down. He does get the blocking foul called against him. But no need for a quick shot there, even though the idea might have been an opening that Kasman saw. Don't take it at that point. Just work the clock.
You're right. And also, don't leave your feet to pass because you make yourself vulnerable and expose yourself for an offensive foul draw by Iona.
However, it is the 7th foul on Iona, 2nd on Cedric Kazmir. It sends Kasman Hayes to the free throw line where he's at 71%. Kasman, this one, 8 points, 2 of 4 from beyond the arc. Kaz had missed his last 13 threes over the last 5 games prior to making 2 of 4 tonight. So an improvement as he got to watch the start of this game from the bench. Now at the free throw line, a chance to get into double figures if he can make 2. First free throw, front end of the 1-on-1 is good. Delaware up by 13. It's 57-44.
Kasman Hayes gets excellent rotation on his free throw. It's a very simple motion, which makes it repeatable. He always snaps his wrist, and the ball has excellent backspin.
And right there, you get the good rotation, hit the front of the rim, and fell right through. Double digits for Kasman Hayes. 4th Blue Hen to reach that mark, led by Ryan Daly, who has 17. Cassell, wild shot, hits the side of the backboard, caroms off the shoulder of Barnett Harrison into the hands of Anthony Mosley. Delaware looking like they're going to go 5-0 at home to start the year.
The 6-time All-Star and player coach of the Atlanta Hawks and St. Louis Hawks, Richie Guerin, a great player at Iona, would not have liked that shot.
It took you almost, as there's a double dribble by Delaware, took you almost all 40 minutes to get it in.
I wanted to keep you on the edge of your seat.
I saw you looking up his name earlier, and I wondered what in the world you were doing.
He was a great player. I'm the only person old enough to
now
remember him playing.
I would have gotten your A.J. English reference. That's about it. 1:20 left to go. We can have some fun because it looks like Delaware going to improve to above 500 to end non-conference play. As Kazmir missed it, Washington offense rebound. His first points of the second half after getting 15 in the first. Mosley's trap, a pass to Hayes, ahead to Bryant. And with 60 seconds left, Delaware a chance to take some time off, and you can hear the crowd. They appreciate what this Delaware team has done on this floor in non-conference play. Washington a little too close to Harris. Harris and he got bumped, and a foul going to be against Washington.
And that's a good call, and Barnett doing a good job there of not swinging his elbows or his shoulders too severely, because But Washington was in his space, and he's got to have an opportunity to turn. Barnett doing a nice job there of being protective of the ball.
Harris, 1 point from the free throw line, one of two, but six rebounds, three assists, only one turnover in 20 minutes of action tonight. Got the start. Gave Delaware some energy. He's done very well, and I think most importantly, as he misses that front end of the free throw, he's been a pest to Jordan Washington in this second
half. He has definitely bothered him and frustrated him in many different ways.
Sevier gets to the rim, fouled on the other end with 43 seconds left. For Iona, they have not scored fewer than 58 points this season in a losing effort to Niagara back on December 4th, and that's Delaware's point total with a lead of 12 points. 46 right now for Iona. They're in jeopardy of not getting to the 50-point mark for the first time this season.
Well, Delaware's team defense, I think, was excellent. A great job on the defensive glass, a good job in transition defense, contesting almost all the threes, and ultimately doing a good job in the second half on Jordan Washington.
Sevier makes one of two. We'll see if Iona elects to foul. Just solid defense right now, and the foul comes by E.J. Crawford. We'll put Mosley on the line. Well, what are your thoughts on that? 38 seconds left. You foul, is your thought process play until the game is over?
It is, Scott, yeah. And I have always admired teams that do that. I think that means you don't have to hack anybody. You shouldn't necessarily go in and dunk in some guy's face, but I think the game needs to be played out. I don't like it when the game stops and people stand around and there's 30 seconds left. I believe it's a game. You play it out. You may not want to antagonize anybody either way. You don't want any hard fouls, but I didn't mind what Crawford did there. I mean, you might say, hey, he shouldn't have fouled. I don't know. Come in and try to make the steal and cut the game down, cut the lead down.
Free throws made good by Mosley, though. 60-47, 31 seconds remaining. Crawford driving on Daly, shot over Daly, no good. Tipped by McGill, he gets it back, tries again and scores. And how about this? What are your thoughts on this? How about a timeout with 26 seconds?
And I also don't mind this either, because I like the timeout, because Coach Grasso is still coaching his team up. And there are things that young teams learn. You learn how to play out games. Hey, let's pretend like this is a two-point game here and how we're going to get back in it. Yes, I do subscribe to that. Now, sometimes coaches that are way ahead call a timeout possibly to substitute, but if you're doing that, I don't think that's correct. But as a losing coach, you're in there, you want to coach your team up the entire way. I'm a big advocate of that. Because you never know when it's going to help you win a game in the future.
Or perhaps Grasso saying this might be the last time I'm the lead man in a huddle with Tim Clues not feeling well, didn't make the trip to Delaware, calls timeout. Iona losing today to Delaware right now at 60-49. Make no mistake about it, Iona, one of the favorites to win the MAAC this season. They are a solid ball club that came in here four games above 500. Delaware beat a good mid-major basketball team tonight.
Yes, they have, and a team that has some good wins on their schedule, and a team that's got some age players who are very solid, and then some young players who have had a good season to start with. Coming in here at 8-4, they're going to leave 8-5. I agree with you. I think they're one of the favorites to win the MAC. I like their style of play. I think tonight they just were not sharp. I'm not going to say that Tim Clues not being here had anything to do with it. I think it had to do with Delaware defending and playing much better and more intelligently at the offensive end, shooting 40%, 37 from the three, getting to the foul line, 16 now, 17 times. Ryan Daly with a great performance, and everybody contributing. I like the new lineup that Coach Inglesby initiated this evening.
Daly made one of two, Sevier a three, rattled it in. Sevier was very quiet to start this game. He'll end with 10 points as that one goes through from beyond the arc. Three second half three-pointers, a foul by Bryant Kazmir with the foul doing so. Delaware up 61-52 with 11.7, and all you're doing now is allowing Delaware to add to their point total, but again, playing the game out. I'm sure Delaware doesn't mind getting some free throws up. Darian Bryant.
And this is good for Delaware as well, Scott. They've got to learn how to play these games. If that's the way Iona wants to do it, then we should go ahead and respond correctly.
Two-shot foul. That was the 10th on Iona. Bryant, first trip to the free throw line. 11 points tonight. He's in double figures. Hayes has 10. Mosley with 14. Daly, as you mentioned, 18 points and a double-double with 12 rebounds. Bryant misses them both. Crawford with a rebound. 10 seconds to go. Sevier wants to push. He's trying to get his average up. Goes to rim and does just that. 12 points for Sevier. And how about that? He hit his average. 5 seconds remaining. Hayes is going to be fouled. 3.1
now,
seconds.
This one I don't understand, Scott. I'm not sure inside 30 when you're down 12, but I like the fact that you're guarding people and playing it out, but that kind of foul there, I'm not sure I understand that one.
3.1 left, the old 7-point play, perhaps.
If you can find that one, you will be certifiable Mensa and genius.
Hey, I am neither. Hayes, 4 of 4 from the free throw line.
And Don McLean will sing a song about you. And by the way, he is an Iona grad as well, the singer of American Pie.
You had 3.1 seconds to get that one in, and you found a way. That's what I love about you. 62-54 after Kasman Hayes. Bounce back performance from Kasman Hayes. He played well off the bench.
Attitude about Kasman. Absolutely. He did not hang his head. He came in and gave us great energy tonight and played a very efficient game.
Jump shot to end it from Iona, does not fall, and Delaware 5-0 to start the season on their home floor. A 5-0 start at the Bob Carpenter Center for the first time since the 1999-2000 season. Delaware improves to 7-6 on the season, ends non-conference play above 500, and matches their win total from a season ago.
And defended their home court and undefeated in the non-conference part of the schedule at 5-0. This is a great confidence builder. I thought Delaware executed their game plan as perfectly as you can be in a college environment. The changeup of the lineup, I think, was significant by Martin Inglesby, and I think his other players responded accordingly. And that's the way a good athlete does it. You don't hang your head. You just go out and fight and try to win your minutes back. And we did it also, let's not forget, without Shavarsky Corbett tonight being injured and not playing at all.
Total team effort tonight. Defensive effort, offensive execution of the game plan. A beautiful win by Delaware. 63-54, the final. We're going to take a timeout. We've got plenty to talk about in the Blue Hens post-game show. We'll recap this one. We'll talk to head coach Martin Inglesby and our player of the game. Plus, we'll get you final stats from the Bob Carpenter Center, where Delaware has not lost this season. 63-54 is the final. Delaware improves to 7-6 on the year. We'll be back in a moment. We'll be right back.